I call Dennis O'Rourke.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. If there was ever legislation that truly defined the character of this government, it would be this legislation. Despite the protestations from the members on the other side, it is National Party ideology to the core. It's that government's intention to privatise everything they can get their hands on, and now state houses and land held for those purposes are up for sale as soon as possible to anyone they can find who will buy it. And, Mr. Speaker, if there was ever legislation that evidenced the failure of this National Government's housing policy and program, it is this legislation. It demonstrates a failure to regulate the housing market and to moderate the housing market, producing a deep and now intractable housing crisis, especially in Auckland. And that, of course, places massive pressure on social housing facilities. And yet the government's priority, strangely, is to sell off state houses instead of investing in more and in upgrading them. This government says it wants to involve the private sector, who is anyone who will cooperate, to do the government's job for it, and they will transfer housing assets to them. But all the bill is actually doing, in fact, is changing the name of the owner of those assets. That's all it does. It doesn't actually increase the housing stock. It doesn't actually improve the quality of that housing stock. It makes no contribution whatsoever to stopping or reversing the housing crisis that we have here in New Zealand today. And, Mr. Speaker, the bill empowers the Minister to direct the sale and transfer of Housing New Zealand Corporation homes for stated housing objectives. But the real objective is just privatisation, which is business as usual for the National Government. And the means for that are direct executive power for the Minister. In fact, far too much direct executive power, sidelining and usurping the role of Housing New Zealand, creating far too much scope for what could amount to corruption with no checks and balances and no accountability.
Crazy.
This Parliament needs to be vigilant about just that kind of legislation, because clearly this government will not be. Now, Mr. Speaker, there are at least 2,000 houses to be fast-tracked sold by this method, potentially billions of dollars. So we do need to be careful about where the money goes, who gets those proceeds, and what they're going to be used for. Now, the Act says, quote, that the proceeds, quote, must be paid to a Crown bank account, unquote. A Crown bank account. And that's actually all it says about that. And I've heard nothing from the other side either about this. No information about what the government's mandate for that money will be. No information about what they're going to do with that money or how it could be used. And Nick Smith made an attempt yesterday in a speech to explain it. And he said that Housing New Zealand has a house building program for which the money could be used. But that's not what this bill says. And we actually have no idea from the bill or from what members opposite have said about what this money is going to be used for at all. We do know that if Housing New Zealand was the recipient, and if it was, by the way, it was to be the recipient, why isn't that in the bill specifically? But if that was to be the case, then how do we know that it will still be used for new social housing or any social housing purpose whatsoever? Because even if Housing New Zealand did get the money, and we are talking about potentially billions of dollars here, will that money, or even part of it, actually go back to the government as a dividend from Housing New Zealand, or even a special dividend of a very large amount. How do we know that wouldn't take place? There's nothing in this bill about that. The members opposite have said nothing about that. So what we could find is that these properties will be sold off and the money just goes back into the government's funds for use for other purposes, or just to create an artificial surplus in this year's budget. And I wouldn't put it past the government, in fact, to do exactly that. If that happened, that would be a disgrace, because the Housing Corporation and the government should be spending all of that money and more, a lot more, on the provision of new and better social housing, state-owned, in New Zealand. And the sector is crying out for just that investment. And so the government should be spending much more than even the sale proceeds from these properties on housing in New Zealand. And yet some members opposite have pretended, you know, that they're doing a great job. Well, I'm sorry, they're not doing any job at all. And nor can they expect the private sector to do so, because it simply doesn't have the resources or the capacity to do it in this country when you look at the size of the crisis that we have now. Mr. Speaker, we can be sure that this government's real intention is simply to sell as many state assets, including state houses, as possible. And the result will be to deepen the housing crisis, because no new state houses will be built as a result of this bill. And Mr. Speaker, lastly, I want to refer to the parts of the legislation which refer to the objectives, because that's the crux of this bill, those objectives. And Mr. Speaker, it simply says, and I quote in the bill with abridgment, quote, the minister may enter into a contract if the minister considers that the entry into the contract is for the purposes of any one or more of the social housing reform objectives, unquote. And then the following clause, quote, a transfer contract may be on any terms and conditions, including as to consideration that the minister may agree with the transferee, unquote. These are very, very wide powers. The minister can sell to anybody on any terms and in reality for any reason whatsoever. All the minister has to do is to relate it to the specified social housing reform objectives. And they are pretty wishy-washy. They are pretty general. They refer to, for example, social housing is of the right size and configuration. Social housing tenants are helped to independence. There is more diverse ownership or provision of social housing. How could any of those objectives, Mr. Speaker, justify the sell-off of state houses or land held for those purposes? And another objective says if there is more, there is to be more innovation and more responsiveness to housing tenants and communities. And another one says, refers to the supply of affordable housing. It doesn't even say social housing, just affordable housing, and yet this bill is supposed to be about affordable housing. What we'll see is properties like the Redcliffe School, which the government wants to sell, then gazetted as state housing land, and then gazetted under this legislation for sale, called, referred to as, in terms of the objectives, as affordable housing, and then sold off to anyone as they think fit, because nobody really knows what affordable housing is. So, Mr. Speaker, I say finally this. This is just privatisation. You can see it from the objectives. You can see it from the government's records. And it's wrong. This government should be investing more, not selling.